Welcome to a new tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to make this cute baby romper. I used a granny square in the front part, and I have made buttons in the lower part, so it will be easy to change the diaper. The length is 15 inch or 37 centimeter, and it will be suitable for a baby from 2 to 6 months old. In a previous video, I've made the suitable baby bonnet. I will put a link down here so you can find this baby hat. I have also made these cute baby booties. I shall also put a link in the subscribing so you can find the video of these booties. And these are the materials I used. I used medium weight yarn, which is 100 gram, suitable for a crochet hook 4 to 5 millimeter. And one pair of scissors, crochet hook 4 millimeter by clover, and two of these stitch markers. I start by making a magic ring. And now I will chain two, one and two. In this ring, I will make two double crochet. I will yarn over, insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. So I will make another double crochet. I will yarn over, insert, pull up the yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through. And now I will chain one. And I will repeat this 7 times. So I will have a total of 16 double crochet in the end. Chain one. I'm at the end of row 1 and I will close the row with 1 chain and a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 2. I will make a slip stitch until I'm at the next space. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And now I will make 3 double crochet in this space. So 1, 2 and 3. I do not count this chain 2 of the beginning as 1 double crochet. And now I will chain 1 and I go to the next space. Next space is in the chain 1 of the previous row, and I will make another 3 double crochet. So 1, 2 and 3, and again chain 1 and repeat this all the way around. I'm at the end of the second row. I finished with 1 chain and now I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 3. First, I will make a slip stitch until the first space. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. In this first space, I will make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And in the same space, I will make 2 more double crochet. 1 and 2. And repeat this in each space. So I will chain, I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, chain 2, 1 and 2, and in the same space I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2. In the end you should have 8 of these stitches. I'm at the end of the third row and I will close the row with a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will make slip stitch until the next space. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And now in each space I will make 7 double crochet. So in this space between those 4 double crochet, 7 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, so continue this in this row. You should have again a total of 8 of these shelves. I'm at the end of the fourth row and I will close the row with a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will chain 1 and I will make a single crochet back post on each stitch. Therefore, I will insert behind the stitch, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through. So, insert behind those V stitches, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through. And make this stitch on each double crochet. And now I arrived at the space between those 7 double crochet and I will make a long single crochet over it. Therefore, I will insert, pull up the yarn and leave a long tail, yarn over and pull through. And now continue making a single crochet back post on the 7 double crochet stitches. So continue this in this row. And now I will start with the sixth round. This time I will make a square out of the flower. Therefore, on the first four single crochet, I will make one single crochet. One, two, three, and four. And now I will make a half double crochet, and on the next two stitches I will make a double crochet, one and two, and now on this spike single crochet I will make a triple crochet. I will yarn over twice, insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, and pull through two. And now I will chain three, one, two, and three. And in the same spike stitch, I will make another triple crochet. So this is my first corner, and now I will make two double crochet, one and two, and in the next stitch I will make a half double crochet, and now I will make single crochet until the next corner I will make. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So nine single crochet, and now I will make a half double crochet and two double crochet, one and two, and again I will make in a spike stitch triple crochet. Chain three, one, two, and three, and in the same space, in the same stitch, another triple crochet. So repeat this in this row. I finished row six, and now I will start with row seven. I will chain two, and I will make a double crochet back post on each stitch. Therefore, I'll insert behind the stitch, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. So insert behind each stitch, and now I arrived at the corner. In the corner, I will make 2 double crochet, chain 3, and 2 double crochet. Therefore, I will insert in the back loop of the stitch. So, insert in here. And make 1 double crochet. And in the next loop, also 1 double crochet. And now I will chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. And now in the back loop, another double crochet. So in the middle loop, I've made 2 double crochet. And in the next, also 1 double crochet. So you keep this stitch on top of it. And now keep on with 1 double crochet, back post, behind the stitches. And in each corner, you will repeat this until the end of the row. I'm at the end of the row, and now I will close the row with a slip stitch. And I will cut the yarn. And fasten off. And now I will start with the middle part. Therefore, I will insert in this corner into the second chain, in the middle chain, and I will pull up the yarn, yarn over, and pull through. And now I will make 39 chain, so I will have a total of 40 chain. And now I'll turn my work and make sure the chain isn't twisted. And I will insert on the other corner into the second chain of the corner in the middle chain and make a slip stitch. And again, I will cut the yarn and fasten off. And now I will make the middle part, therefore I will insert in the back, in the middle, so this is the middle, and I'll insert and pull up the yarn, yarn over, and pull through, and chain 1. And now I will make a double crochet on each chain. And I go all the way around. So when I arrived at this part, on this chain, I will make 1 double crochet. And on each double crochet, also one double crochet until I'm back at the end. I'm at the end of this row. I've made a total of 67 double crochet stitches, and now I will close the row with a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will chain two, one and two, and again I will make a row of 67 double crochet stitches, and I will make a total of 9 of these rows, so I will make 8 more rows. So this is the middle part I'm working on. So I'll have a total of 9 rows before I start with the decreasing. So now I've made 9 rows, and now again I will cut the yarn and fasten off. So this is the back part, and you can see this line of the turning point, so it's not a big deal if it's on the back. And now I will go to the front part. I've put a stitch marker on each side. So I've just measured which is the middle side. And now I'm going to insert on this side. I put a stitch marker in the middle part of the side, and I'm going to insert in here. And I will yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through, and make another chain. I'm now going to start decreasing. In each row I will decrease 2 stitches on each side. So I'm going to do it with making 2 double crochet together. First I will yarn over, insert in the first stitch, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2, and insert, yarn over, insert in the second stitch, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2. I have now 3 loops on my hook, yarn over and pull through the 3 loops. And now I'm going to do it another time on the next 2 stitches. Yarn over, insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2, yarn over, insert in the next stitch, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2. I have now 3 loops on my hook, yarn over and pull through the 3 loops. And now I will work 1 double crochet on each stitch, but on the last 4 stitches I will also make 2 double crochet together. So now work 1 double crochet on each stitch. So now I arrived at this part, and I have 4 stitches left, and on this stitch I will also make 2 double crochet together. So 1 and 2, and I have 3 loops on my hook, yarn over and pull through, and make another 1 and 2, and yarn over and pull through the 3 loops. So this is the front part, and now I am going to turn each row. Therefore I will turn it. And chain two, one and two. And now I will do the same. In the first two stitches, so this is not a stitch. I do not count this. Insert in the first stitch. And in the second stitch. Yarn over and pull through. And do it again. Insert in the first. And in the second. Yarn over and pull through the three loops. So now I'm going to make one double crochet on each stitch. And in the last four stitches, I will repeat the same as in the previous row. So now I'm at the last four stitches and I will repeat this. Make two double crochet together. And on the last two stitches, also two double crochet together. So now I will turn my work again and I will repeat this on the next stitches until I have 10 stitches left. I now arrived at the row and I have 9 stitches left. And I will turn my work and chain two. And in this row, I will make 9 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And now I will turn my work and I will make the buttonholes. I will chain two and now I will make the buttonholes. I've chained two and I will make one double crochet in the first stitch and one in the second stitch. And now I will make one chain, skip one stitch, and in the next make one double crochet. And I will make two more double crochet, one and two, chain one, skip one stitch, and I will make three double crochet, one, two, and on top of this chain, a three. And now I will chain one and turn my work, and I will make a single crochet on each stitch. And now I will cut the yarn and fasten off. So that was the front part. And now I will start with the back part. I will do the same as in the front part, except I do not make the buttonholes. So I will grab my yarn and insert just next to this stitch, next to the stitch marker. And chain two. And in the first two stitches, I will make a double crochet together. And I will do the same in the next two stitches. Also, a double crochet together. And now I will make one double crochet on each stitch. But on the last four stitches, I will make two double crochet together. Just like in the previous rows. And I will see you in the end of this work. I arrived at the 13th row of the back part. And now I have 12 stitches left. So in this row, I will decrease two stitches. Therefore, I will insert in the first stitch and in the second stitch and make the stitch together. And now I will one, crochet 8 stitches, and I will crochet the last two stitches also together. So now I have 10 stitches, and I will chain 2 and turn my work, and I will make one double crochet on each stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, plus this chain 2 of the beginning. And I will make one more row so it will fold inside and I can put the buttons on the other side. So I've made a total of 16 rows on the back part, and you can see this is the front part where I've put the buttonholes, and I can sew the buttons on the back part, so I can close the button. And now I will make a single crochet on the side. Therefore, I will chain 1 and I will insert, yarn over and pull through, and I will go all the way around. And it's a little hard sometimes where you have to insert and make sure it's not too tight or too loose. But it will give a nice finish if you make a single crochet. It's not necessary, but if you hear funny noises, it's because my bird is taking a bath. So this is what you can hear. I have finished the border and I have sewed 2 buttons in the back so I can easily fasten this point. And now I'm going to make the suspenders on top of this side. Therefore, I will insert in this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the fifth stitch, I will insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through, and I will chain one. And now I will make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I will turn my work. And I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And I will make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I will do this in each row. I've made 16 rows, and now I'm going to sew it on the back. I can sew it with just a needle, but I can also make slip stitches. So, and now I'll cut my yarn and fasten off, and I will make another one on the other side.